Excuse me for a second. Internet, what's up? It's Thursday and I'm your buddy, Mitch Santoni, that gives you the throwbacks. And today we got Autobot engineer Wheeljack from Generation 1. Look at this guy. Look at this. I am super excited. I'm going to explain why as I go through this, but I do want to show off the box, the packaging. This is like 1984 again, man. I haven't had a Wheeljack box pristine in my hands since I was taking it home from Toys R Us on my birthday when I used my Toys R Us gift cards to get myself a G1 Wheeljack. Man, I can't wait to open this. Now, if you're at home flipping out because I'm opening a G1 Wheeljack still in package, don't worry. This is a fourth-party knockoff or whatever you want to call it. This is not an original, but it's very much a replica of an original. So I have this guy, and I'm super-duper excited to have one that's complete now because I lost one of the fins, one of the spoiler pieces, one of his wings, one of his cannons, and I only had one cannon and no missiles. I had none of the missiles either, so I have all four missiles now. So super excited to get this guy adorned with the proper stuff. So he comes with a beautiful full-color instruction booklet. Look at how they used to look, man. So cool. Pictures of the actual toy and how to do it, how to do the thing right there. It even gives you a step-by-step instructions. I love it. There are stickers in here. I'm not going to apply them tonight. I do have Toy Hacks ones that are usually better quality than these fourth party ones. So I'll end up putting those on them eventually, but tonight we're just gonna go stock. Come on in here, buddy. Oh, look at the thing. It's amazing looking, isn't it? Just incredible. I don't know why, but he's filthy, but beside the point, I don't care, I'll get him cleaned up. But it's a fourth party thing, so I mean, you know, you're gonna get something. Who knows what you're gonna get? I'm gonna take these stickers off too because I have replacements for them. They were all misput on, crooked and dirty and whatever, but I don't care. I'm gonna take care of you, buddy. I'm gonna take care of you like I didn't take care of my original one. This one's gonna get cared for and loved, just like 1984. The familiarity, the shape, the weight. Even, hold on, yeah, even the smell, man, it just brings me back to 84, October of 84, and I just absolutely love it. So the only gimmick really in this mode is that you can open his hatch and stick something in here. A little guy, maybe a little Diaclone driver, but it's got some molded in goodies here for the pleasure of your eyeballs. And here we go. On my G1 shelf, I got a beat up, missing pieces, yellow, nasty, stickers all over the place, Wheeljack that I played with and I wore out, man. And I'm going to be really happy to retire him because it's the only one I have, the only G1 Wheeljack I have. I got this guy now. He's going to stand in for the shelf presence. He's going to be my new guy. We're going to take care of that sticker for him. We're going to put the other stickers on it. And I can't wait to just stare at this thing looking at me all static-like. And just look at how gorgeous this guy is, all decked out with all the regalia. He's got the shoulder cannons with the beautiful choking hazard missiles, the old-school ones. And I love the clear wings, man. I miss that left wing for so long. And now I finally got him with a left wing again. I'm so happy. Hey, you want to know the best part, too? I didn't think this was going to work, but it absolutely does. Check it out. Ba-doo! And pew-pew! Spring-loaded, baby! Well, let's do a little comparison with a Bumblebee Deluxe and a Rise of the Beast Wheeljack. I think we got to run down his posability. We're going to have to take off one of these missile launchers to do that so I can show you all of the movement in the arm. Now, the arm is tight enough to hold itself up, and it will go all the way around. You can even move his wings. These will go up and down. Look at that. This will go 360 degrees. I love this. Love the arm, man. Oh, maybe not. Maybe the door gets in the way. However, you can close the door and get what you want out of that if you like. The hands, they kind of spin in and out. They're a little bit loosey-goosey here. I may be able to tighten these a bit just to try to get this a little bit tighter. He gets stickers all over his arm, too. I don't like that look, so we're going to keep that blank. And that's it. That's it. That's all you get. That's all you're going to get. His head does turn left and right, so there's that. But these things here are connected in a one big giant tree stump. It's Thursday. It's a throwback. This one's in the books. We just took a look at G1 Wheeljack, a figure I've never reviewed before because mine was so beat up. And this guy needs a little cleanup work himself, but we had to show him off as soon as he got in the door. He arrived today, and he hit the review table minutes later for you guys. Take care. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe to everything in the Mid-San Antonio Network. I'll see you guys later. Arrivederci.